Kira Siva here, and welcome to Emotional Mastery 101, your guide to living a happy, healthy, vibrant emotional life. This series is designed for all of you beautiful people out there going through a big transition that's causing a big transformation in yourselves and your life. If you haven't checked out the intro video, please click pause on this one and I'll include it in the notes below and just check it out real quick. It's not very long. And you'll see why I'm making this video series. If you've already joined me through the first couple of videos, thanks and welcome back. Today, we are going to talk about emotional responsibility. Those beautiful words that mean so much. So we're gonna just dive right in today. In our last video, we talked about how to feel your feelings, which is really the foundation that we are building up all of your emotional mastery skills on. So if you haven't checked out that video, definitely go check that one out and start practicing. It's awesome. All right, so emotional responsibility. Those two beautiful words changed my life, and I'm sure they'll change yours. Now, if you're someone that's had really positive emotional role models in your life, this is all gonna be a friendly reminder. For the rest of us who didn't always necessarily see that, this is gonna be brand new information that can really change your life. This one concept has so much power in it. I can't believe it. So let me tell you a little something about myself. I'm a big-hearted do-gooder. I love people, I love helping people, and I've been listening to people's problems since I can remember. I've always been that person that people just like to come to and dump everything on, and I can't say that I've disliked it. It's been pretty fun, and it's just something I've always done. I've always been that really solid, stable, emotionally grounded person for people, and also sometimes I haven't had the best healthy boundaries, and sometimes I haven't really understood where their problem lies and where my own lies. In fact, I'm pretty guilty of something being that I've called being a white knight. I will also add the link below to what a white knight is, but essentially it's someone who runs into somebody else's life and picks them up from whatever despair and takes on their problems and helps them, you know, go up and up and helps them kind of get back to balance. Now, what I learned from being a white knight, now a recovering white knight, is these two concepts: emotional responsibility, healthy boundaries. So as someone who's been in codependent relationships and just loving, I just love to help people, so I've just naturally kind of taken on people's issues, I've had to really learn about this. And it's why I know that these concepts are going to change your life if you don't already know about them. So let's talk about what emotional responsibility really is. So emotional responsibility really is saying, I am responsible for all of my feelings, my words, my thoughts, and my actions that arise because of my feelings. It is really saying that when I have a problem, I understand that it's because something inside of me is being triggered, and it's not necessarily that the outside world is doing things to me. It's that these events are happening around me, and then some belief, some value, something is arising in me, and I'm taking ownership over that. Now, if you've been someone in some very complicated relationships, these lines can feel pretty blurred, which is why it's even more important for you to really deeply understand that if other people have a problem with you, it's not necessarily you that's in control of that. How many times have you been in an argument with somebody where you didn't even know you were doing anything wrong, and then they've come and the way that they've expressed it, you feel blamed, you feel hurt, you feel confused, and then it seems like all of the responsibility for fixing the problem is on you. It can be kind of frustrating, and it's hard. And how many times have you done that to other people? Did you get very far with it? Did you argue for hours? There's a lot of little working pieces with emotional responsibility. Things like using I messages. When you ate my sandwich, I felt angry and disappointed because I had spent so much time making my sandwich and I was really looking forward to eating it. That's just kind of, it's sort of a silly example, but it's one example. There's also things like when somebody else is doing something and you're so certain they're doing it because of some reason. And as it turns out, the reason that you assign them for doing those things and the reason they're actually doing those things, pretty far apart. And the reason for that is because something in you that was hurt and wounded is now being triggered by some event. So with emotional responsibility, it's really like before you start expressing all of your blame and anger and hurt to the person, you step back for a minute and you look at your what's going on, which is why it's important to be able to feel your feelings. You look at that, you observe that, and you ask yourself, why do I feel this way? Is there a belief that I'm holding about what I feel like this person should do? Is there a value that's being not honored? Maybe it's someone stepping on your self-worth. Boundary lines, is someone stepping on my boundary? What is going on there? And the point of doing this before you get yourself worked up into an emotional frenzy and ready to attack is literally just having some time to figure yourself out and understand what need is trying to be fulfilled so that you can express it in a way that it can be fulfilled. What I have seen with people is that, especially when they're people that love and care about you, people aren't typically out to hurt you. They're not typically out to get you. And I can't tell you how many times I've mediated between people or been that person where both sides are going off and I just wanted to be like, stop, both of you. You're both making up stories about each other. Neither one of you is correct. And if you just sat down like two grown adults and talked about this, you would find out that person A has a certain need and person B has a certain need. You don't need to add blame and egoism and attacking and all of that in there in order to get the needs met. Most of the time, the people in your life want to help you. They want to love you and encourage you and lift you up. And if you don't have people where you feel like certain that that is the way they feel about you, you need to get people in your life that you are certain feel that way about you, because that's a part of having a healthy emotional life, is being able to have healthy relationships with other healthy people. So the main place I learned a lot of about emotional responsibility from was actually the Gordon Training Institute. I'm not a teacher of theirs, I'm not, you know, connected or anything, but I will add some links down below that talk about who the problem belongs to. And I am not gonna go up too much into it today. I could do it in the future, but I just want you guys to go and read that because it will really help you understand when you are owning the problem, when the other person is owning the problem, and when the relationship is owning the problem. And that's a really, really crucial understanding, especially if you're a big-hearted do-getter, and especially if you're going through a big transition that's caused a big transformation. And the reason that that's important is because when you're going through big transitions, you are dealing with a lot of uncertainty, a lot of unknown, a lot of things are changing. It can feel like the world has fallen down around you. And you need some tools to be able to navigate through that in a beautiful and graceful and easy way. So this is a really core one. Emotional responsibility also lets you build healthy boundaries. I can guarantee you that there are a lot of you out there that have a hard time with this one. And it's not because you are not completely awesome and amazing. It's actually because We don't have a lot of really great role models of this in our media, in our music, in the things that influence us. I do not care what socioeconomic class you come from. I don't care what education you have. I don't care how old you are or how young you are. It astonishes me that the healthy boundary thing just isn't really a big thing in the world. We don't talk about it. I don't know why we don't talk about it. I'm sure in certain circles it's, you know, a regular conversation. But as a culture, we don't really talk about this. And if you are a person where you don't have this around you now, this is a really, really important thing because you don't have any way of gauging what a healthy boundary looks like. But when you start to really understand emotional responsibility, you can say, I am actually responsible for how I feel. Or like, if somebody else is using really blaming language at you, well, you did this and you did that, and because you did these things, I feel these ways and you're controlling me, all the things, right? Well, with emotional responsibility, when you understand, I never actually did something that was trying to hurt you or harm you. And now that I understand that you are just using blame language because you don't understand emotional responsibility or how to use I messages effectively or how to active listen or any of that good stuff, I can kind of not engage my own ego in that kind of conversation and look past those things and start listening to the needs and also start really being like, actually, I didn't do those things for those reasons, and I really feel like maybe this is something that you should look at. It just helps you navigate your own emotions and everybody else's emotions. You know, we live in a pretty emotionally confused world, so it's just a really, really good practice to have. So I will definitely leave the resources below about the Gordon Training Institute, because like I said, that's where I got a lot of my understanding from. I'm sure there's tons of really good articles out there as well, and we can definitely dive deeper into this if you guys want to. So if you do, leave a comment below on this, and also let me know how you're practicing emotional responsibility in your life. Let me know how you're practicing healthy boundaries. When you share your stories, your successes, and your challenges, it helps every single person watching these videos. It helps every single person who's commenting on these videos, and that's really, really important to feel like you have a community and a group to talk to, because for some of you out there, we're it. You're not gonna have a lot of other people to talk to right now, but as you start to be a part more of the community, you're gonna have other people that you can really connect with that are emotionally responsible, that have healthy boundaries, and you guys can really help each other out. This is a time of community, it's a time of support, and it's amazing that we can do this over the internet, that I can record a video and help you at some point in the future, and that you can leave comments and help somebody else. So, thank you for joining me. Please subscribe below if you like this video and give it a thumbs up. And I will see you in the next video where we talk about the cycle of your thoughts and your feelings and how they co-create each other. Thanks.